Is your iPhone lock screen picture stuck in the past? Back when your 30-year-old daughter was 3 and you had a full head of hair? My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And in today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to breathe new life into that iPhone. Back in the day, we could only pick one picture to use as our iPhone lock screen. So people would pick the picture they loved the most and leave it there, year after year, new iPhone after new iPhone, until it was just hopelessly out of date. In many cases, they didn't know how to change it or how easy it was. But now Apple's made things even easier because instead of just having one lock screen picture, you can have multiple. And they've made it easy to create them and given us all sorts of amazing tools to make them beautiful and completely customized. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to create multiple beautiful custom created lock screen photos with ease and swap between them anytime you want. And if you stick around until the end of the video, I'll teach you my MacWhisperer power tip about how I keep my iPhone lock screen current perpetually. So let's hop on in and get started. The first thing we want to do is get to our lock screen. If your phone is unlocked, the easiest way to do that is press the side button on the right side like this. Now what you want to do is press and hold in the center of the photo like this, and it'll slide back, entering into the lock screen customization section. In the bottom right-hand corner, we've got a friendly little plus button. Clicking that jumps us right into the customization screen. From here, we can easily and quickly create all sorts of great lock screens. I know that it can feel a little overwhelming when you first walk into this section, but Apple's made it really easy for us to almost instantly create a lock screen. They've broken it down into multiple simplified categories, like the featured category that changes on a regular basis, giving you all sorts of new options as time goes on. The suggested photos section that immediately picks the best pictures from your photo library to instantly create a new lock screen with just a simple click. They've created the photo shuffle category and the weather and astronomy category that allows you to pick different planets or even current weather conditions to show on your lock screen. There's the kaleidoscope section with beautiful colors and all sorts of different styles and designs. The emoji section where you pick a handful of emojis and different designs and patterns for them to show up on your phone. The unity, the pride section, and the collection section with some classic iPhone wallpaper selections. And even the color section down at the bottom for you to create a super simple, easy color gradient for your lock screen. But you know me. I'm a bit of a control freak, so I like to create my lock screens from scratch. Up across the top of the lock screen section, you're gonna see all these different options. I really love a lock screen based on photos, so let's just hop into that section directly by clicking right here. When you first open this page, you'll be in the featured section. This is where Apple collects the photographs from your library that they know will look great on your screen. And again, you can just click one and be all set up and ready to go right away. But let's do a little more work than that. If you look to the right of the featured section, you'll see the live photo section, because on today's lock screens, you can actually use a live photo, which is a photo with a bit of motion to it, so that every time you pick up your phone, it shows you jumping into the ocean or doing a fun dance or maybe a picture of your wife showing her stuff. As you scroll down, you'll also find a section of some of your favorite people, your favorite furry friends, pictures of nature that you've taken, or even pictures of cities that you've visited. Whatever you want to do, right from here, you can instantly create a gorgeous lock screen. But I'm going to take us a level deeper. Up at the top, we've got this album section here. Let's click on that. This opens up your photo library. So if you've done a good job of organizing your photos in your photo library, you can go right into one of your favorite albums and pick some awesome pictures from here. If you haven't gotten around to organizing your photo library, check out this video up here to get some of my best tips about how to easily organize a photo library. But don't worry, even if your photo library is a complete disorganized mess, Apple's still got your back. Click on the Photos section right here, and in the Search field, You can type in any person, any place, any subject, and Apple will look through your photo library to find those pictures for you. This can be really helpful for me to update that picture of my daughter and I. Let's start by typing her name in right here. There it is. Let's go ahead and click on it. And now I've got a bunch of pictures of my daughter, but maybe I'd also like a picture of me there. Let's come back to the search field and let's go ahead and type my name in. I'm going to click on photos of Dylan. And now I've got a perfectly configured collection of pictures of my daughter and me to select from. Let's scroll down and find one that's a little more current and a little more fun. Here's a great picture of my daughter at a recent wedding. Let's go ahead and click on that one. When you choose your picture, you can pinch and spread to perfectly position it wherever you want on your screen. With certain photos, especially portrait photos, you can easily create a bit of a depth effect and even position yourself or the other subjects in front of the clock, which is kind of a cool way to do things. Once you've gotten your picture where you want it, you can select all sorts of pre-configured filters. Different photos will unlock different filters. Down at the bottom, you'll see we're currently on the natural filter. That means no filter at all. But if I swipe from the right to the left like this, now I'm in a black and white filter. Or now I'm in what they call the duotone filter or the color wash filter. There's all sorts of different options we can choose from, and we'll even explore some more of them in the next lock screen we create. Down in the bottom right corner here, you'll notice this little color circle. Clicking on that can allow you to change the color of the backdrop. So let's go ahead and change it to a blue. That's a little hard to see. I think we'll stick with a nice light orange. I think I like the natural filter best, so let's swipe back to get that nice, beautiful, colorful picture so the flowers and everything else pops. But up at the top, I'd like to give the clock a little more style. By simply clicking on the clock here, you can change the color by choosing any of these colors down below or the color wheel on the far right side, and the slider allows you to choose how deep you want that color to look. Let's pick a nice yellow. Makes it a little bit brighter just like that. You can even change the font of the clock itself by clicking on one of these different styles up at the top. When you find the one you want, you can adjust its thickness with this slider here to give it just exactly the right style that you're looking for. Let's click the X button here. That looks pretty good. Let's click the Add button in the upper right corner. This takes us to the next section. Now, in addition to the lock screen, we've also got the home screen, which is the picture that shows up right behind your apps. Now, if you want to use the same picture for both, just click where it says Set as Wallpaper Pair and it'll take care of that automatically. But again, I'm a control freak. I want to customize the home screen as well, so I'm going to click the Customize Home Screen option down below. As I do that, I get a number of options down at the bottom, including flat colors that I can choose or a gradient that I can choose. But I want to go into the photo section again and pick a specific kind of photo. As I come into this photo section, I'm going to swipe on the top side here until I get to nature. I find that nature photos look great behind your apps on a home screen. So let's find one that we like here. I'm going to scroll right down here and let's take this one right here. It's nice. It's easy to see. I'm going to go ahead and pinch and spread a little bit to get us a little bit more zoomed in on those beautiful mountains. And now let's see what kind of filters exist here. I'm going to go ahead and swipe just to explore a little bit. Don't forget the little color circle down at the bottom that you can use to change that style a little bit, change how it looks. I think that's a pretty easy and good way to go. Let's click the Done button in the upper right-hand corner here. As we do that, it gives us a basic preview of what that home screen is going to look like. If you're happy with it, click the Done button in the upper right-hand corner and you have now created a brand new photo lock screen. Let's create another one just a little bit quicker so you can see how easily you can actually do it. I'm going to swipe over. I'm going to click the plus button. I'm going to go back into photos. In this case, let's stick in the favorite section and I'm going to just scroll down until I find another beautiful picture of my daughter at her wedding. Let's go ahead and click on it. Now, this is a different style picture and down at the bottom, you're going to notice there's all sorts of additional filters. Let's flick through and find one we love. That looks kind of cool. It's a nice black and white picture of her with the backdrop being a different color. I'm going to pinch and spread a little bit so I can see her pretty face. And then I'm going to change the backdrop color from yellow to something just a little different. Let's go for a green. and adjust it just like that. Let's come in, let's click on the clock here. Go ahead and give it a different style, just like this here. And let's give it a different color. Let's make it nice and white so that it stands out. And just like that, I'm already ready to take the next step. Now there's one other thing you should know about these lock screens, and that is you can actually add widgets to them really easily. Widgets are small applications that show you information so that you can see the weather or your next calendar appointment or quickly launch into some of your most used apps. In this case, I'm just going to stick with the picture without the widget and put it back into the position that I like and click the add button in the upper right hand corner here. Now again, I don't really like the wallpaper pair. Let's click to customize our home screen. Let's go back into the photo section here. In this case, I've got some great new pictures that I just recently took. Let's just scroll down until I find the one that I like. I think this one's perfect. Gives a nice splash of color on that home screen, just like that. Find it where you want it. Check to see if any of the filters look the way you want. I think I'm gonna keep it just colorful, just like that. Let's click the Done button here. Confirm that it looks good with the apps in front of it, and click the Done button again. And in a matter of a couple of moments, we've created two of them. And from this section, you can easily swipe between the two of them or even go back to the old picture that you had. When you figure out which lock screen you want to use, simply scroll to the one you want and tap on it and it will become active. Now, if we swipe up from the bottom, we can see our beautiful poppies in the background. And when we lock our screen, there's my beautiful daughter on her wedding day. Perfect. In just a moment, I'm going to share my MacWhisperer power tip about how you can easily keep your phone lock screen updated perpetually with almost no effort. But before I do, if you've got a question or something you'd like to share, drop down to the comments section and put it down there. I love to hear from you guys. And if you got great value out of today's lesson, give it a thumbs up so other people can find it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so that you're always alerted whenever I drop new videos. With that being said, let's hop into the MacWhisperer power tip. You know, it's great that we can easily change our photo lock screens, but who wants to do that again and again and again? Fortunately, Apple gave us the Photo Shuffle lock screen. And by simply clicking right here on Photo Shuffle, you can select pictures of any people in your library, either selecting or deselecting the people that you want to see the most pictures of. Or my personal preference, click on the album section down here and set it to any album in your photo library. Or just set it to your favorite section. We tend to update our favorite section on a regular basis without even thinking about it, which means if you set your photo shuffle to the favorites album, you will automatically see your newest and most favorite pictures on a regular basis. Down here, you can choose the shuffle frequency and let it be each time you tap it, anytime you lock it, hourly or daily. I'm going to choose on lock so that every time I open up my phone, I've got a new beautiful picture to look through. Let's go ahead and click use album and take a look at what we've got. Right here, we can see a preview of how some of these photos are going to look, and we can even filter them as we go. Tapping on any particular picture just changes it to the next picture in that album, and you can still customize your clock, your font, add widgets, anything you want to do. And when you click the add button in the upper right hand corner, you can either set it as a wallpaper pair or customize that home screen. In this case, let's just do a nice color gradient, nice purple color like that, and click done. Now, every time I pick up my phone, I got a new fresh picture to look at, and it never gets stale. That's what I've got about how to easily customize your iPhone lock screen and create beautiful pictures that you get to look at every time you pick up your phone. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done on your Mac products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time.